Trying to capture potential clients' data is hard, especially when you don't have an easy way for them to sign up or provide their details. In this case, I'm going to show you how to embed a really easy form on WordPress using GoHighLevel forms. So let me show you how right now. This is my WordPress demo site, and I'm going to show you how to embed the GoHighLevel form on here. Now, you can embed the form in a fixed form. That means that when the page loads, you can see the form, or on a pop-up widget that looks pretty flashy. So let me show you how. Now, this is my main dashboard for WordPress site. And to embed the form from GoHighLevel, you don't actually need the lead connector plugin, but I do recommend that you install it so you can take advantage of the funnels and the chat widget. Now, to do this, let's get started on our GoHighLevel dashboard. We're gonna head on over to obviously the company that we're going to use, head on over to sites, forms, and we're going to add a new form. So I'm going to show you step by step how to do this. Now in this form, it's a form builder where we drag and drop. We're going to drag and drop just a few elements. We'll ask for the phone, the email, and we're going to keep it simple. Now, before I show you how to style this, I'm going to embed this first. So I'm going to save the form. I'm going to integrate, and there are several options available. There's a sidebar, which is my favorite one. You can do it at a fixed left or right. Polite sign in. Now, if you're using polite sign in, do remember that we're using a GoHighLevel chat widget. So if you do this, put it on the left. There's the pop-up where it just pops up in the center, and the inline, where it's just inline of the page. I'm going to use the sticky sidebar just to show you. And there's the trigger type. In this case, we can set it by scrolling percentage. That means that when someone scrolls 25% or 50% of the page, it's going to pop up or show. Now, I think this is one of the best methods because if someone's interested in your site, it's not gonna pop up in the beginning, but after a certain scroll. Also, seconds, we can make this pop up after a certain X amount of seconds. So if someone's there for 20 seconds, 30 seconds, that means that they're interested and will show the pop-up for the form or always show. In this case, I'll keep always show so I can show you really quickly how it displays. Activation options, activate on visits. So it could be after 5 visits, 2 visits, etc. Deactivation options, so deactivate after showing X amount of times, deactivate once leads is collected. Okay, now you can copy the link and share the link and just use the form, but in this case, obviously we want to embed it. So we're gonna copy the embed code and we're gonna go into our WordPress dashboard. Now on our WordPress dashboard, there's 3 methods that we can use to embed our form. The first one and the easiest one is to install a plugin for the header and footer. So this is the safest way that you can embed the form because it's super easy. Just use any one of these elements and you can just add the code into the header. The second method that I'm going to show you is the traditional way, which would go into an appearance, theme file editor. And in the editor, we're going to look for the header. Here it is, header PHP. Now in this case, it's called theme header. It might be just called header depending on the theme that you're using. We'll scroll down here, and after the body section, we are going to add this code. So let me go ahead and find this here. Here's the head, here's the body. Okay, so we're gonna add the code. That's the iframe. I'm gonna update this. Now, by adding the code here, that means that it's gonna show and display in every single site of our website. So here's the demo site. I am going to refresh it. And here's the form displayed. You can see that there? Full name, phone, email, and submit. That's how easy it is. And if I go to another page, I'm gonna view it also. Now, another method to add this is to add this individually in certain pages. So if I go to pages and I go, for example, where's my sample page? Here it is. If I edit this page, in this case, it's Gutenberg. I've actually added one here. So I'm gonna remove this HTML. All you have to do is add HTML. Here we go, selected. Add the iframe code, and it's gonna pop up on this specific page. It won't show on any other page on this site. Now that's the third method that you can use. Now, in terms of customizing this, well, it's actually super easy. Once you decide what you want to use, go ahead and remove this for now. We can go into style, and in style, there's several things that we can do. For example, I can change it to inline form, which is a bit more compact. The show labels, maybe I don't wanna show labels, I wanna keep it clean. It says already in here, so maybe keep it cleaner by removing the labels. I'll leave it like this for now. We can change the background for this, the border style. Right now it's dashed. I mean, you could probably see that, but if you want to use line, there we go. It's a solid line, or you can use none. The border, we can make it thicker or thinner. corner radius, I kind of like the roundness. It makes it look more modern. So I kind of like around 15. That works out. And then we have the option for the width. So for example, maybe on the site, it just looks too big. You want to make it thinner. So maybe 300. There we go. That might look more appealing to the client who's going to visit your site. There's the padding, if you want to use that there. Shadow, if you want to add some shadow. Horizontal and vertical. Let me change this color here. There we go. Let's add some blur. There we go. That looks nicer. And the spread. And there we go. Added some shadow, make it look a little bit more modern. A field style, I can change the background color and all of that. Padding, shadows for that. The labels, I can change the colors for that. And the text, the font, the placeholder, and custom CSS. If you just want to totally change the look of the form, you can just use custom CSS if you know how to use that. You can also use the agency branding if your plan allows it. There's the options for this. Obviously, change the name so you can locate it, especially when you have several forms available. The unsubmit, you can open URL or a message. Enter URL here if you want to use that there. The Facebook pixel ID, Facebook pixel event. And again, once you have everything styled again, go ahead and save it, integrate form, and grab the new embed code so you can update it. So it displays the new updated style that you've just created. Now, like I said, if you're struggling to get contact data from visitors, well, make it easy for them. Add a form. Make it easy for them to just have that little pop-up there, add the data, and they are boom. You have a new lead that you can start using your marketing strategies to start selling and use GoHighLevel to the maximum potential. But there you go. If you want to know how to embed forms, there you go. Use this video. I thank you all for watching, and that's a wrap.